All of you wanting to learn about accounting. Welcome to this video. Today I will illustrate the fundamentals of accounting by telling the story of Michael who is starting his coffee shop. The video will guide you with examples on the revenues and expenses incurred on the income statement. Don't forget to share this video with a friend that it's eager to learn as much as you. Are you ready? Let's go. Michael, as a young hard-working entrepreneur, decided to open a coffee shop named Coffee & Go Sweet, nearby the town university. Being smart, he decided to visit an accountant practice in order to familiarize himself with the documentation needed to open the coffee shop. There he meets Marianne, a CPA working in the accounting practice, who explains to Michael what is an income statement and its importance for financial control of the business. Marianne points out that an income statement will demonstrate how profitable Coffee & Go Sweet was over a specific time period. The time period in question can be a week, a month, 3 months, 6 months, or a year, following what Michael deems as the most beneficial for his business. She continues by adding that profitability reporting should be looked according to the following two components. 1. The amount earned, known as revenues. Coffee & Go Sweet major source of income are the fees it charges for his coffees sold. These fees are the revenues of the business. Revenue is the income earned by an individual or a business from the sale of any products or services offered. Revenue is also known as sales, and we can calculate revenue by multiplying the price of the product or service times the number of units sold. The revenue recognition principle, one of the fundamental accounting concepts, dictates that revenues are to be recorded as soon as they are earned. Following the accrual basis of accounting, as opposed to the less favored cash method of accounting, the revenues are recorded when they are earned, meaning when the act in fact happens, and not when the company receives the money. For example, if Michael sells 4,000 coffees for $2 each in January, he has actually earned $8,000 in fees for that month. As coffees are paid by his clients in the act of order, Coffee & Go Sweet will recognize in January the $8,000. Let's imagine now the following event. Michael also sells cupcakes in his coffee business, and he receives on January 27th an order to deliver 50 cupcakes at $5 each for January 30th. He charges his clients for these fees, which are $250, and his conditions require that the client pays by February 4th. As the delivery job was completed in January, even though his clients will not pay Coffee & Go Sweet until February 4th, the accrual basis approach of accounting requires the $250 to be recognized as January revenues. The income statement for January will demonstrate how profitable the company was in delivering the cupcakes in January, that it's when costs are matched with these revenues. In January, Michael made an entry to accounts receivable and sales of $250. In February 4th, Coffee & Go Sweet receives $250 as a payment from his client. These $250 in receipts will not be considered February revenue because it was previously reported as revenue in January when it was earned. In February, Michael will do an entry to report the revenues as a decrease in accounts receivable and an increase in cash. Now, Marianne moves on to explaining the second component for profitability reporting. 2. The costs incurred to generate those revenues, known as expenses. An expense is the cost of operations that a company incurs to generate revenue. As the popular saying goes, it costs money to make money. In order to maximize profits, a company needs to keep expenses under control while increasing their revenues. Common expenses include payments to suppliers, employee wages, factory leases, and equipment depreciation. Regardless of when the business paid for the expenses, all costs that the business incurs in the month of January should be part of January income statement. For example, if Michael hires someone to assist him with January delivery of cupcakes and agrees to pay him $25 on February 4th, the expenditure must be included on the January income statement, as it makes no difference when the $25 is handed out. What counts is when the expense was incurred, or in other words, when the job was completed. In January, Michael will record $25 in accounts payable for the incurred but still not paid cost for delivery, and will balance it with an increase in costs by the same amount. In February, Michael will record an offsetting entry in accounts payables and a decrease in cash. Even though the money will not be paid out until February 3rd, the $25 charge is recorded as a January expense. This is known as another basic accounting principle, the matching principle, meaning the recording of expenses with related revenues. The matching principle is critical in determining how lucrative a company was during a certain time period. Marianne explains to Michael that including the $25 on the January income statement would result in a match between the cost of a service needed to deliver the cupcakes and the revenue generated by delivering the cupcakes in January. She is pleased to see that Michael already understands this fundamental accounting theory intuitively. To generate income in January, the company had to expend certain costs in January, even though these costs would not be paid until February. Marianne explains to Michael that the income statement is a little more difficult than she just described, but for now, she simply wants Michael to understand some fundamental accounting principles and terminology. Marianne is making sure that Michael knows one important point that many seem not to understand. An income statement's goal is to 1. Report the revenues earned by the company's activity during the period, and 2. Report the expenses incurred by the organization during the same period. The income statement's objective is to indicate a company's profitability over a certain time period, and the difference between the revenues and costs is generally referred to as the bottom line, and it is named as net income or net loss. And now, let me know on the comment section below if you understood what is the main benefit of using the accrual basis of accounting. I want you to know that it was great to do this video, and if you have enjoyed and still did not subscribe to the channel, today is the perfect day to do so by clicking on the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching, and I will see you again soon.